Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas is directed by Henry Selick. It stars Danny Elfman, Chris Sarandon, and Catherine O'Hara. The Nightmare Before Christmas is about Jack Skellington, who is the Pumpkin King of Halloween Town, and is in charge of making the holiday a scary time. He's great at his job, but he's found himself bored and unsatisfied because of the same routine every single year. So when he discovers Christmas Town and the holiday of Christmas, he decides to take on the challenge of being Santa for the year because he believes that Christmas is the key to bringing him happiness as opposed to doing the same old thing that he's done every single year. He just wants something new in his life. First off, I don't think this would be a proper review of The Nightmare Before Christmas if I didn't talk about the music. It's so beautifully sung, it's so well composed by the wonderful Danny Elfman, and in this musical, the music really lets you in to the characters' minds and what they're feeling, what's going on. It moves the plot forward in a very, very natural way. And I just feel like this is what every musical should be doing. If you're not doing that in your musical, then something's very wrong, and it does it so well here. There's a lot of debate circling this movie as to whether it's a Christmas movie or it's a Halloween movie. And while I do enjoy watching this one around that time of year because I feel like it's more special when you watch it around that time of year, I'm a firm believer that you can watch this movie really whenever you want. I watch this movie at least one or two times, excluding around Halloween or Christmas time, just because I love it so much. I feel like if you do that, you're gonna love it the same way that I love it. Also, the score in this movie is so wonderful, like I was just talking about, that I'll listen to this year-round, like when I'm in the shower or when I'm on a long car trip or something, just because I think it's so good that it deserves to be listened to year-round. I would like to talk about the stop motion in this movie. I think it's superb, even though this movie is almost 30 years old, which is crazy to think about, but it's almost 30 years old. The stop motion in this still really holds up. It's superb. Tim Burton, along with Henry Selick, they've been able to do something really special, and they know how to direct stop motion. You know, Tim Burton's done quite a few different stop motion things before, and so having him along with this director, they've really put out something special that has really stood the test of time, and I believe has paved the way for some modern stop motion classics that we like today. Another thing that I really love about this movie is just the world that it sets up. The world that it sets up is so enticing and so original. And I love the idea of the plot and how there are all these different holidays run by people or these creatures that represent the qualities and events in these holidays. That's such an original thought. Something else that really goes along with the world in this movie is how every single person in Halloween Town just looks vastly different, you know, because they're all supposed to be these different weird monsters with all these different personalities and the way that they talk and then the way that they move. And I'm sure that was a nightmare to try to get on the screen and make all these different figures with all these different expressions and things that they have to do. But their hard work in this movie has paid off completely. It looks absolutely incredible on screen and really stands out. It's really fun to watch. And lastly, I wanted to talk about the characters of Jack and Sally. I love these characters. I love the characteristics, their reasonings for what they're doing. I feel like they're pretty relatable characters. You know, I feel like all of us at some point in life have been bored with where we are and what we're doing, and we've made a selfish decision that has gone wrong and we've had to fix things. I feel like that's so relatable and something that people can watch and really take home and hone in on. But my one complaint with this movie is that I feel like the Jack and Sally relationship, and mainly their love relationship, was kind of forced and pushed. And I honestly feel like I would have liked it better if Jack and Sally really would have just been like pretty good friends, or like have become pretty good friends in the movie, but instead they had to push for something that was that like they made them fall in love or something like that. And I feel like that's a small complaint that you can really overlook, but I don't know. I'm just not the biggest fan of that. And I think that's gonna do it for this review. A pretty short review on this movie, but a pretty short review for a pretty short movie. The runtime is only like an hour and 17 minutes. You know, you can sit down and watch this movie pretty quickly. But I really didn't have too much to say on this. I think I'm gonna give it about 4.7 stars or like an A for a letter grade rating. I really like this movie. I do have that one kind of issue, like it's just a very small issue that I have with it. It's really not that big of a deal, but I feel like maybe that could be a little bit better. It could be changed. Like I said, that's going to do it for this review. If you liked what you saw here, please subscribe, leave me a like, leave me a comment, let me know what you think, and the review is now concluded.